Hi everyone, this is Atik. I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Hope everyone are fine. Today, let us start the third part of operating systems concept. And this topic is very, very important in competitive exams, in interviews, as well as in your academics as usual. Okay, what is the name of the topic that I'm going to discuss with all of you? Hope you can see on the board, that is deadlock. Okay. If I am not wrong, if we ask any person that what is a deadlock in operating system, they will think that it is one of the tough concept in operating system. But in my point of view, this deadlock is one of the easiest concept in operating systems. Okay, whether you agreed or not, but after watching my video, hopefully 99% of the students will say that yes sir, it is easy. Why means our main goal of running this channel, my main goal of running this Engineering Drive channel is to make you learn something in a simple way. Everybody will teach, but learning in a simple way is very, very important, because if we learn in a simple way, automatically we can go and implement it in different levels. So without consuming too much of your time, let me start. What is a deadlock? Before I am going to start a deadlock, I will give one general example, then I will go to the topic. Let us say there are two students. How many students? Two. Let us say student A and student B. There are two students, A and B. Both are friends. Student A is having one book, B1. Student B is having one book, B2. There are two students. Both are friends, A and B. A is already having one book, B1. B is already having one book, B2, which they are preparing individually. Okay. And now the situation came. You know, during exams, friends want to exchange their books. Let us say scenario came. A want the book of B. What is the name of the book of B? B2. Similarly, at the same time, B also want the book of A, because they required at that time. So what is the name of the book of A? B1. Okay. Now, we have kept one condition here. What is that condition? If A will give the book, if A will release his book B1, then only B can take that book. Hope you understood. If A will release intentionally, yes, I want to give the book to B. If A's permission is there, then only B1 book will be given to B. Similarly, vice versa. If B is willing to give the book B2, then only this B2 will be given to A. Hope it has been clear to you. Okay, let us say, what is deadlock now? I will be explaining now. You have understood the scenario. If A is not willing to give his book B1, similarly, B is also not willing to give his book B2. But A wants the book of B, B wants the book of A. Whether it is possible? Simple answer, it is not possible, because A is not willing to give his book. B is not willing to give his book, but they want each other's book. So in this case, what happened? The execution or the flow of activities will stop. We call this stoppage as deadlock. What we call this stoppage? We can say that this permanent interruption is known as deadlock. Deadlock means in which flow of normal activities will not take place. Flow of execution will not take place. Okay, hope you understood. If A is ready to give B1 book, then it will be easily given to B. Similarly, B is ready to give the book B2, then B2 will be easily given to A. But they are not ready. If they are not ready, then only deadlock will occur. Now, same example I will take with our operating systems now. With this, your doubt will be cleared now. Let us say, I am having two processes. There I have taken two students, A and B. Here I am going to take two processes. First to process P1, and let us take the second process name P2. Okay, then I will take two more resources now. Two more things, those are resources. Let us say this is R1, one resource, and this is R2, second resource. Okay, P1 and P2 compare with two students A and B. Resources R1 and R2 compare with books B1 and B2. Same, you see, this is our operating systems example I am taking now, so that it will be clear to you. Now, so in our example now, A is already having one book B1, B is already having one book B2. So book B1 is assigned to A, similarly book B2 is assigned to B. Now what happened here also in our example, the resource R1 is already assigned to process P1. So this resource R1 is the property of P1. Hope you have understood. Similarly, this resource R2, okay, this resource R2 is the property of P2. Here A is having one resource B1, B is having one resource B2. In our example, P1 is having one resource R1, P2 is having one resource R2. Now what happened up to here? No problem. P1 process wants the resource R2 now. Similarly, P2 process wants the resource R1. So how we can write this? What type of arrow I can use? Let me show you clearly. P1 is requesting for R2 resource. Who R2 resource belongs to which process? P2. And P2 is requesting for the resource R1. This R1 resource belongs to which process? P1. Okay, so we can write here in simple way like this. P1 is waiting for R2. Similarly, P2 is waiting for R1. Then what about this blue lines? How we can write? R1 is assigned to P1, which means here we can write assigned to. Here also we can write R2 is assigned to P2. Assigned to P2. Okay, now you listen how the deadlock will occur here. This graph, there is one name for this graph, I will tell you later. Just to see here, R1 is a resource, this is the property, it belongs to P1. Similarly, R2 is the property or resource belongs to P2. Now the problem is P1 is interested in R2, P2 is interested in R1. When they will get, of course they are waiting for that, but when they will get this resource R2, when P1 will get resource R2, when P2 should release that one. Hope it is clear. When P1 will get the resource R2 means when P2 will release the resource. Similarly, when P2 will get the resource R1 means when P1 will release the resource R1. Same way which I have explained with students and books. Student A will get the book of student B when student B will release the book. Similarly, when student B will get the book of student A, that is B1, when student A will release the book. Here also what happened? P1 is waiting for R2, which is held by P2. P2 is waiting for R1, which is held by P1. So in this way, what happened? We are getting one cycle here. This cycle will never terminate. And we call this cycle as, what we call this cycle? We call this cycle as deadlock. Here the execution will permanently stop. The flow of activities will not take place, and hence we call this situation as deadlock. A deadlock is a situation in which two or more processes are waiting for the shared resource. This R1 and R2 are shared resources. In which two or more processes are waiting for the shared resource and neither of them are willing to release their own resources. Okay, so here P1 is not willing to release his own resource R1. P2 is not willing to release its own resource R2, which means other processes, they will not get the others' resources. This situation is known as deadlock. So if you understand this diagram, it is enough. You can explain deadlock in very, very simple way, my dear students. Okay, hope it is clear. So the concept of deadlock is explained with the help of this graph. We call this graph as resource allocation graph. What we call this graph name? This graph is known as resource allocation graph, in which we can make use of processes and resources to explain the concept of deadlock. Okay, so hopefully everyone have got a clear picture of what is a deadlock and how a deadlock can occur. Okay, and there are four necessary conditions also for a deadlock to occur. Those four conditions are mutual exclusion, hold and wait, no preemption, and circular wait. If all those four conditions are satisfied also, then deadlock will occur. So this is my purpose of explaining to a deadlock concept to you is to show you the use of resource allocation graph. Okay, so with this, let us close this today's session of video. I will continue our part 4. There I am going to introduce about scheduling algorithms. Those are very, very important part, or we can say they are the heart of our operating systems. So let me close my today's session. Everyone, see you soon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.